Life in the UK Practice Test. Episode 4, Chapter 3, Early Britain, Hunter-Gatherers, the First Farmers, the Bronze Age, the Romans, the Anglo-Saxons. Hunter-Gatherers. The first people to live in Britain were hunter-gatherers, in what we call the Stone Age. For much of the Stone Age, Britain was connected to the continent by a land bridge. People came and went, following the herds of deer and horses which they hunted. Britain only became permanently separated from the continent by the Channel about 10,000 years ago. What you need to know. The first people to live in Britain were hunter-gatherers. What we call the Stone Age. Britain only became permanently separated from the continent by the Channel about 10,000 years ago. Possible question is, which of these statements is correct? A. The first people to live in Britain were early Christian missionaries. B. The first people to live in Britain were hunter-gatherers. The correct answer is B. The first people to live in Britain were hunter-gatherers. The first farmers. The first farmers arrived in Britain about 6,000 years ago. The ancestors of these first farmers probably came from Southeast Europe. These people built houses, tombs, and monuments on the land. One of these monuments, Stonehenge, still stands in what is now the English county of Wiltshire. Stonehenge was probably a special gathering place for seasonal ceremonies. Other Stone Age sites have also survived. Scarra Brae on Orkney, off the north coast of Scotland. For much of the Stone Age, Britain was connected to the continent by a land bridge. People came and went, following the herds of deer and horses which they hunted. What you need to know. The first farmers arrived in Britain from Southeast Europe about 6,000 years ago. These people built houses, tombs, and monuments on the land. Stonehenge was probably a special gathering place for seasonal ceremonies. Following the herds of deer and horses which they hunted. Possible question is, the first farmers arrived in Britain about 6,000 years ago, famous for A. These people built houses, tombs, and monuments on the land. B. They built roads and public buildings, created a structure of law, and introduced new plants and animals. The correct answer is A. These people built houses, tombs, and monuments on the land. The Bronze Age, around 4,000 years ago, people learned to make bronze. We call this period the Bronze Age. People lived in roundhouses and buried their dead in tombs called round barrows. The people of the Bronze Age were accomplished metalworkers who made many beautiful objects in bronze and gold, including tools, ornaments, and weapons. The Bronze Age was followed by the Iron Age. The language they spoke was part of the Celtic language family. They made the first coins to be minted in Britain, some inscribed with the names of Iron Age kings. People still lived in roundhouses, grouped together into larger settlements, and sometimes defended sites called hill forts. A very impressive hill fort can still be seen today at Maiden Castle, in the English county of Dorset. What you need to know. Around 4,000 years ago, people learned to make bronze. People lived in roundhouses and buried their dead in tombs called round barrows. Who made many beautiful objects in bronze and gold, including tools, ornaments, and weapons. The language they spoke was part of the Celtic language. A very impressive hill fort can still be seen today at Maiden Castle, in the English county of Dorset. Possible question is, which language was spoken by people during the Iron Age? A. Anglo-Saxon. B. Celtic. C. English. D. Latin. The correct answer is B. Celtic. The Romans. Julius Caesar led a Roman invasion of Britain in 55 BC. This was unsuccessful, and for nearly 100 years Britain remained separate from the Roman Empire. In AD 43, the Emperor Claudius led the Roman army in a new invasion. One of the tribal leaders who fought against the Romans was Boudica, the Queen of the Iceni in what is now eastern England. She is still remembered today, and there is a statue of her on Westminster Bridge in London, near the Houses of Parliament. Areas of what is now Scotland were never conquered by the Romans. And the Emperor Hadrian built a wall in the north of England to keep out the Picts, ancestors of the Scottish people. Parts of Hadrian's wall, including the forts of Housesteads and Vindolander, can still be seen. It is a popular area for walkers and is a UNESCO, United Nations Education, Scientific and Cultural Organization, a World Heritage Site. The Romans remained in Britain for 400 years. They built roads and public buildings, created a structure of law, and introduced new plants and animals. It was during the 3rd and 4th centuries AD that the first Christian communities began to appear in Britain. What you need to know. AD 43, the Emperor Claudius led the Roman army in a new invasion. One of the tribal leaders who fought against the Romans was Boudica. She is still remembered today, and there is a statue of her on Westminster Bridge in London, near the Houses of Parliament. The Emperor Hadrian built a wall in the north of England. UNESCO, United Nations Education, Scientific and Cultural Organization. The Romans remained in Britain for 400 years. During the 3rd and 4th centuries AD that the first Christian communities began to appear in Britain. Possible question is, which queen is remembered for her rebellion against the Romans? A. Anne. B. Boudica. C. Elizabeth D. Victoria. The correct answer is B. Boudica. The Anglo-Saxons. The Roman army left Britain in AD 410 to defend other parts of the Roman Empire and never returned. Britain was again invaded by tribes from Northern Europe, the Jutes, the Angles and the Saxons. The languages they spoke were the basis of modern-day English. Battles were fought against these invaders, but by about AD 600, Anglo-Saxon kingdoms were established in Britain. These kingdoms were mainly in what is now England. The burial place of one of the kings was at Sutton Hoo in modern Suffolk. This king was buried with treasure and armor, all placed in a ship which was then covered by a mound of earth. Parts of the west of Britain, including much of what is now Wales and Scotland, remained free of Anglo-Saxon rule. The Anglo-Saxons were not Christians when they first came to Britain, but during this period, missionaries came to Britain to preach about Christianity. Missionaries from Ireland spread the religion in the north. The most famous of these were Saint Patrick, who would become the patron saint of Ireland, and Saint Columba, who founded a monastery on the island of Iona, off the coast of what is now Scotland. Saint Augustine led missionaries from Rome, who spread Christianity in the south. Saint Augustine became the first Archbishop of Canterbury. What you need to know. The Jutes, the Angles and the Saxons. The languages they spoke were the basis of modern-day English. The burial place of one of the kings was at Sutton Hoo in modern Suffolk. Missionaries came to Britain to preach about Christianity. Saint Augustine became the first Archbishop of Canterbury. Possible question is, what did Saint Augustine and Saint Columba do during the Anglo-Saxon period? A. They invented new farming techniques. B. They were courageous warriors. C. They were early Christian missionaries. D. They were leaders of an uprising in Wales. The correct answer is C. They were early Christian missionaries. Hope you like this video. Please feel free to write your suggestions in comment section for future videos. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching this video.